I'm Mike from Mike's Carburetor Parts. I'm in the process of rebuilding a Holley 2-barrel Series 2280, and I have it all cleaned up and ready to go. I got the float bowl out here, and the first thing I'm going to do is put in the two main jets. That's the smaller ones here, and they go down right there yonder. Use a decent screwdriver for this kind of stuff so that you're not chipping this brass. About the only way these things really get worn. Okay. We have... Now, these can be different. You can see this one here is just a plug, more or less. These are your power jets. And this one on this side basically has this plug. Some may have a mechanical or a vacuum operated. So pay attention when you're taking it apart. And in fact, do like I do and take a lot of digital pictures when you take it apart. And assuming it was right to start with, the pictures may help you get things back where they belong. It's saved my bacon more than once. I can't remember everything. All right, so over here we're going to put our little power piston, power jet, whatever you call it, and it goes like so. It's got this little needle that goes in it and the spring that's hooked to the bottom of it, and I'm pretty sure that's it. I'm going to check my picture. I don't do many of these 2280s. They're far and few in between. And the exploded view in this situation doesn't help me either, so let me look. Hang on just a second. Yeah, that's all there is to it right there. So, we got the spring, if yours like this, and we got the needle that goes up in here. I got it all cleaned up. It goes down here in this hole. And... this one's kind of tricky if you don't have the regular carburetor tool for this. And I try not to use anything special because people watch the videos generally don't have all the tools, carburetor tools, probably not. So anyway, you got to get that needle pushed down with the screwdriver and then get it in there tight. Okay. So there you go. The next thing we're going to do is put our... check ball and our weight in there. This kit comes with two check balls. We'll just need one of them. Okay, they're different sizes, so I'm just going to take the old one and match it up. And the two check balls in this case, it's a smaller ball. The other thing you could do is just look at the hole and see if it falls in the hole. Oops, wrong hole. Okay. I think it went down in there. Why didn't it come out? It's definitely in there. Oh, here. Weird, it won't just fall out of there. Just floating around. There we go. Okay. So the hole we want in is right there. So there we go. And then we have our weight that goes in next, right there. Okay, so then let's find our gasket, and we'll put it on here. And I had a hard time getting the gasket cleaned off this carburetor. think it's just because of the metal. Alright, you go in there one of these ways here. Okay, so spray it with some silicone spray lubricant, and that'll keep it from sticking the next time. Alright, so we got it on there in our Venturi. So we got our ball and our check weight there. And we'll slide that down there. And let's see, which screws was that? I think it was probably these long ones here. There it is. So yeah, two longer screws. I'm pretty sure that's where they went. Okay. There you go. So the next thing we're going to do is, let's see, the ball is in there. Yeah. Alright. I have to watch myself because when I do a video, I'm not paying attention as I should to the carburetor. Alright, so I'm going to put the float in next, and I'm going to turn the video off for a minute and come back with another video because I forgot to round up the new float. Plus, it's a real complicated mess to put together, so I'm going to do it first so I'm not wasting all the video time on it. I'll be right back.